It is a sad fact of life that we will all die. And although we have become very capable at putting off death longer than any civilization has ever done before us, all our deaths still remain inevitable. What happens after death? Of course, there's a number of ways of answering this. From our side of the divide of death, death is simply the word that we use to describe the body and brain shutting down. It's the word we use to describe the separation of the body from the soul. Those who sit with people in their last moments talk about a moment when the person's soul appears to part from their body. Those who've lost loved ones testify to feeling as though after death their loved one simply isn't there. Once the body is no longer animated by their soul, we acknowledge that they are dead. Now, all of those statements are ones that we could probably agree on and make from our vantage point on our side of the great divide of death. We do not know exactly what happens in the moments after death, since no one has ever spoken to someone who's died. Except that that's exactly what the first Christians claimed to do when they spoke with and listened to Jesus in the days and weeks following his resurrection on Easter Sunday. You see, Jesus is different from other religious teachers and other philosophers who like to talk about death and the afterlife. He's different because he's been there and he's come back. The essential claim of the Bible, then, is that upon our physical death, we depart from this world and our soul goes to be with, either goes to be with God, or it goes to be away from God, to the place of the dead. The Bible's word for being with God is paradise. The Bible's word for being away from God is Hades. And it's here in this state that we shall remain, the Bible says, until the eventual and final resurrection from the dead, when all of us will be called to give an account of our lives before God. And at that point, we will hear a verdict spoken over our lives by God. It's at this point, essentially, that those who want to be with God will receive just that, God. And they will live with him in a new earth, in a new body, much like Jesus's body that he had after his resurrection. And those who don't want to be with God don't get to be with God. They are sentenced to an existence away from him and his presence. Ultimately, God is kind, he is loving, and he is just. He gives us what we want. If we want him, we have him. If we don't want him, we don't. The question for us to consider now on this earth, in this life, is, do we want God? Well, do you? If you do want God now, then you can encounter him and enjoy a relationship with him now. And if you don't want God now, what makes you think that after death you'll want him then? You see, the ultimate fabric of the universe is not just blind, chaotic chance. It is the loving person of God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Salvation and heaven isn't an imagined preferred vision of the future. Salvation and heaven is God. What makes heaven heavenly, then, is God. And if we want God, we can have God. That is all possible because of the loving kindness of God demonstrated in Jesus. And it's because of Jesus' resurrection from the dead that as Christians, we believe that it's this that happens after death.